guys, welcome back to my channel. Today, as you can tell by the title of this video, I'm going to be chatting about potential Aberdeen managers because, of course, our former manager, Jim Goodwin, has been sacked. And Aberdeen are, of course, on the hunt for a new man to manage the club. So there's been a few names talked about over the last few days. Well, sorry, over the last 24 hours. One of the main names is Paul Lambert, who is a former Celtic player. I can't remember if he managed West Ham or West Ham or Villa. Fix that. So if any of you guys know any of the teams he's managed, please let me know in the comments, because I think he's either he might have managed Villa or West Ham, I don't know. But he has managed a few clubs. Oh, I still can't get this right. There we go. But honestly, I don't care about who we get as a manager as long as they're good. That's all I care about. But I do kind of care. That doesn't really make sense. But I just want a good manager for Aberdeen. Another big name that has came up is Chris Wilder. Oh my God, I still can't get this right. Perfect, there we go. One more time. Yeah, that should be it. So another big name is Chris Wilder. He used to manage Sheffield United. And I don't know if I would... I do want him. I was very happy if he came up north. Was he the one who got Sheffield United 7th place in... or 8th, whatever it was, in the Premier League when they first came up? I think it was him. But honestly, he is a cracking manager, in my opinion, I think, because he took Sheffield United to the top 10 of the Premier League in their first season back in the Premier League for a while. So I think, anyway. But honestly, there's also a few other names. I don't know if you watched the video I did with Aaron Jones. We spoke about David Martindale and Jack Ross. There are another two managers who we could potentially be getting, like I said, in the video I did with Aaron. I don't want either of them. I feel like Martindale isn't really he's doing a good job at Livy, but I just think Livy's the club for him. I think he really suits Livingston. He's doing the McCracken job. He really gels with the players, gels with the fans. I don't think he'd have the same connection up at Aberdeen. But if we do get him, which I don't think we will, it wouldn't be the end of the world, but I think I'd rather have someone better. Jack Ross, like I said in the video I did with Aaron, I do not want. It wouldn't be the end of the world if we got him, but I just don't really want him because obviously his run with Dundee United, and I just don't think he'd be right to come to Aberdeen. But another man who there's been talk over is Neil Lennon. He was obviously spoken about when we sacked Stephen Glass. He was on the equation when we were going after obviously when we got Jim Goodwin at the time, but Neil Lennon was one of the candidates, and he's one of the candidates once again. I don't know if I want. Neil Lennon is he's a good manager. He's obviously won Celtic the treble when he was manager. Did he win the Hibs Scottish Cup? Or was that someone else? I can't remember. But he obviously did well with Celtic and Hibs as a player. So they play for... I don't know. I think he played for Hibs anyway. But honestly, whoever we get, they better be good. Apparently, there's this Norwegian man we're after. And apparently, he was the same... It was the person we were after when we sacked Stephen Glass. And he said, no, no, no. But... hopefully that won't happen. If he said no to us last time, I don't see any reason for him to say yes this time. But honestly, Aberdeen Football Club is a bit of a mess right now. You know, we were in a we weren't in the worst position in the world when we came into 2023. Obviously, we had just lost four games on the bounce. Celtic, Rangers, St Mirren, Kilmarnock. And going into those four games, I expected at least 6 points out of 12, because I said we should be beating St Mirren and we should be beating Kilmarnock. Of course, we didn't beat either of them, but obviously the St Mirren game was pretty much down to our fantastic captain. But I just think, obviously, the Rangers game, we were winning and then it just got, well, they got 7 minutes out of nowhere and they won. But obviously the Celtic game, we tried to sit back and it bit us right in the bookie and we got beat. So obviously that was 2022. In 2023, we drew 0-0 with Ross County. Fun fact, well, a fact, really not really fun. We've only drawn two games this season and it was Ross County away and Ross County home. Obviously the Ross County away game, we were 1-0 up in the 87th minute or 88th. And then the last kick of the game, they equalised. It was just a bit of a shock, really. But obviously, we then drew 0-0 to Ross County. They went out for a draw. They got their draw. Fair play of them. I just cracked my finger. That really hurt. And then, obviously, we beat St Johnstone 2-0. Duke got a brace. And then we went to Hampden. Yeah, we did. We went to Hampden. And obviously we got beat. We went 1-0 up and we conceded two. We conceded one in extra time. Stuart gave Rangers a big helping hand once again. He aided our opponent a victory once again. And then of course we went to Tynecastle. They ripped us to shreds. Went to Darvel, we got beat, and then we went to Easter Road and they beat us 6-0. So we've scored two goals we've scored three goals this year altogether, and we've scored two goals in the league. And we've also conceded, quickly do the math, 2, 5, 7, that's 6. Yeah, we've conceded 14 goals this season. Sorry, that took me a while. We've conceded 14 goals this... No, haven't we? Wait. So we can... I don't know why I'm doing this. Conceded 2 to Rangers, 5 to Hearts, so that's 7. 1 to Darvel, which is 8. And then 6. 14, yeah. Jeez, oh man. So we've conceded 14 goals this season. And... Well, sorry, not this season. 14 goals so far this year. And it's been poor. Obviously, this is kind of turning into a bit less, not really about potential managers, because that's what the title is. But, it might not, I don't know what it'll be. It might be like, I'll figure it out. But you guys will know, obviously. And I, at the time of recording, I guess I'm still thinking about it in my brain. But, like I said earlier, Aberdeen are a bit of a mess of a football club right now. But as long as we can get a manager in before Wednesday, we could maybe turn around. Obviously, we've got two home games coming up. St Mirren and Motherwell, two matchday vlogs. Don't you worry about that. And then who's it away? Is it Saints away? Or is it... I'll have to check who we've got away after that. But if it's Saints, it'll be three matchday vlogs. But I don't know. I'll check after this, after I've finished recording. We really need to win these two home games. If we don't, I'll pop the table up there, or there, probably there. We're seventh in the league right now, so we're desperately going to need to win these two home games. Obviously, Motherwell are our bogey team when it comes to them coming to Pittodrie. Obviously, we broke our... we finally actually won at Fir Park for a long time. The last time we won at Fir Park was... we beat them 2-1, it was when we beat them 3-0. Cosgrove dinked the keeper, McGinn hit in the top corner, and Zach Viner battered one off the post. I was at that game. That was a cracking day. If you actually watch Stockton's vlog, you can see me, but it's quite hard to pick me out of Stockton's vlog of that game. And that was obviously the last time we beat Motherwell until at Fir Park, until no, yes it was, and of course until this season where we beat them at Fir Park. But obviously we got beat 3-2 at Pittodrie, which was a bit disappointing. However, I still feel like we are going to, well, hopefully we can win our next two games, because they're both at home. We've been very good at home this season, which I think the only games we've lost at home this season would be Motherwell, Celtic, Rangers, and would that be it? I think so. Let me just quickly double check. We beat Killy, we beat St Mirren, we beat Saints, we drew against Ross County, we beat Hibs, we beat Hearts. Also, I was mascot for the Hearts game. Which I think of other home games. That must be it. Beat Livy. And yeah, that is that it? I think so. If it's not, I'm stupid. But obviously we lost to Motherwell and the Old Firm. And I just don't really know what to expect from Aberdeen in the coming few days. Obviously the last 24 hours, the last 48 hours really, have been disappointment. Obviously I was thinking, okay, before the Hibs game, I was thinking, okay, maybe we can, if we have a go at them, never give them a rest, we could beat them. And then we went out and maybe like, because of how bad we were, it almost seemed like the players didn't want Goodwin, so they played rubbish intentionally to get rid of him. That's what it seemed like to me, because we were so poor. We didn't really threaten their goal that much. I mean, if I'm being honest, I switched, I turned, like I said in the video I did with Aaron, it took me for Hibs to get to the third goal for me to go back to go off Red TV and watch something else. That was, I don't know what else happened, but from what I've heard, we were shocking, we didn't give any effort, and they tore us to shreds. So, honestly, I guess I'm just going to end the video there, but I hope you guys did enjoy this video. Please do like and subscribe, and I'll see you soon for the next video on my channel. I don't ever slow up, no I don't take shit. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up and make a statement.